Get on the first pass, you old.
Okay, where do you want to go first?
Where am I going to go first? I guess go by the international.
Welcome aboard the Paul Beasley Class 40, headed for the 1982 World's Fair. We'll be there.
Energy will be generated by a combination of LNG and advanced gas turbines. Moreover, cold energy derived from LNG at minus 160 degrees centigrade is utilized at the same time.
After miles of walking through countless exhibits, it was good to relax at the Stroh House, a Bavarian garden type of restaurant, which was a mecca for mirth and merrymaking. Culture was exhibited in the costumes and songs of native entertainers. This figure is a symbol of the European Economic Community, which unites 10 nations in a common goal to improve and sustain economic well-being in Europe, guarantee peace among its members, and help other nations with trade and aid. Of Mexico were recalled by likenesses of ancient gods. which adorned the facade of its position. Unique attraction from the Eastern Caribbean was a steel band whose members play on oil drums shaped, polished, and tuned into fine musical instruments. The beauty and pageantry of Korea were brought to Fairgores by that country's traditional folk dances, glimpsed here on their way to a performance. With a theme of eternal values in a dynamic nation, Saudi Arabia reflected on its past and look toward its future. This natural silk cloth is called the Satara, a door covering for the Kaaba, the house of God in the center of the Grand Mosque in Mecca. Verses from the Quran are embroidered in Arabic letters done in calligraphy with gilt-plated sterling silver threads. This is the United States Pavilion, facing the waters of the World Lake and situated at the center of the 72-acre exposition. The aluminum industry's vertical axis wind turbine uses curved rotor blades, which allow it to accept wind from any direction. Once started by a motor in its base, a wind speed of 14 miles per hour will keep it producing low-cost energy. The family of windmills symbolized the need for decentralized energy sources, a portion of the Australian exhibit. Prefabricated in Peking of enameled wooden panels, this 54-foot tower guided the visitor to the China Pavilion.
Oh,
Artifacts of ancient splendor gave the visitor a rare opportunity to observe the culture of a country which had never before participated in a World's Fair. This is an actual portion of the Great Wall of China, one of the original seven wonders of the world. And recently, excavations revealed a 2,000-year-old terracotta likeness of an ancient Chinese warrior. Officially called the Family Fun Fair, the World's Fair amusement area contained the usual midway excitement, plus one of the world's largest Ferris wheels, which carried its riders 162 feet above the fairgrounds for a spectacular view of the fair site and the Tennessee River.
Yep, they're stopping off now, aren't they?
The quickest and most comfortable way to get from one end of the fair to the other was via the Sky Transpo chairlift.
Near the end of the night.
Fog dancers from Davidson County, North Carolina. They represent energy in action. Tiny, but terrific, is the best way to describe this 1/2-inch scale model of a surface, whose hand-carved characters, meticulously reproduced from old circus posters, presented a faithful reproduction of life under the big top. Thousands of tiny lights turned night at the fair into a twinkling fairyland, as laser beams projected a fast-paced show of swirling colors onto the facade of the Federal Express building and wrote their greeting of welcome in many languages. Energy Express, blaring its catchy musical theme and flashing very colored lights, meandered through the streets of the fair. Day ended with a traditional display of spectacular fireworks and many pleasant memories of the 1982 World's Fair.